Advanced analytics provides the context to see the patterns in your data at scale. It can also reduce the time it takes you to find answers in your logs when you're overwhelmed and time is of the essence. For example, in a security context, you need to locate the problem before you can actually resolve. Hello, I'm Odell Gordon. Welcome to Advanced Log Analytics. And here we have some snort data. Snort is network intrusion and detection software. We have 62 pages of messages over the last 15 minutes. Now, if I'm new to my system, I'm just learning about it as a network security engineer, and I want to find a particular attack, I can use LogReduce to help me. What LogReduce is going to do is group the messages by similarities. It's going to use machine data analytics to say, all right, a good part of this message is the same, and there's some differences, but I want to tell you, this happens over 700 times. Now, this is great. I came down from 61 pages of messages to one page of signatures. I could take a look, and if I believe that, you know, suspicious file names or a scan attempt was to blame, I can dig deeper into a particular message. I can take a look at what happened a minute before and what happened a minute after to see where my attacks may have increased after this occurred. I can find out if this is really my smoking gun. To be even more certain about the time period of what's happening, I can use LogCompare. LogCompare is going to let me say, how is this different or similar to what has happened 24 hours ago or 7 days ago or some custom time period that I choose? Now, those signatures that had once said, hey, this is an occurrence, they also come with an account of likelihood of the percentage of similarities from the last time. It will also tell me whether something is new today or whether it was there yesterday, but it's gone. So what if I want to be a little bit more specific about my filtering here? I can go up here in my query and I can add a new line. Now, I could continue on the same line, but I like putting mine on a new row. So when it comes to error checking, I can easily go to that row. So I place my cursor at the end of the line, and then I'll use Shift Enter or Shift Return. One of those two will work. Now I have a new row here. Now, again, as I mentioned, I want to filter down and narrow down. So I want to introduce you to a where clause. So I need to use a pipe to continue because I'm on a new row. And I'll use a where clause. And you'll notice that that where is in a fuchsia color. The fuchsia color indicates it's an operator. And I want to do where. And again, as I mentioned, I want to filter down. So I'll use a function here. And it's called isNew. Okay. And this function is going to find those new items for me. Okay. What I should have left once the results come are all of the signatures that are unique to today. There's only one in this instance, and it says others. Now, I might have a bad file attachment or something along the lines there, but I was able to focus in on that. And I can say, well, this is probably not a good signature. So I can demote it, this here down. If I thought that this was a relevant signature, I could promote it and hit the up arrow. I can also edit it as well. If you're interested in learning more about LogReduce, LogCompare, you can go up in your home tab, down in your learn link, and you can go down into your docs. I hope you enjoyed this presentation. We look forward to hearing from you in one of our upcoming courses. Thank you.